Today we have Professor Swami from Sai Vidya Institute of Technology. Good morning, sir. Thank you again for giving us this opportunity. So to begin with, I would like to ask you the first question for the day. You have held key positions at education institutes throughout your professional career. What are the key factors that you keep that keeps you connected with the education sector?
Okay. Madam, I have been in this teaching profession for the past almost 35 years. Since 1986, I am in this profession. And some of the factors that are, that keep me to be connected with the education system are providing high quality education is the only way ensuring development of individual student in particular and the nation in particular. And the second thing is the student community needs proper guidance. And another factor I can mention is the gap between the industry and the institution is very wide. And this has to be, and this particular issue has to be addressed. I think these are the major points, I think.
Right, sir.
Right? Need to be addressed.
Right.
And I have a strong conviction that I have the capability of contributing in this direction. Right? And this conviction makes me to stay connected with the education system.
Amazing, sir.
Okay.
So, I'd like to go ahead with the next question. Associated of Sai Vidya Institute of Technology, what is your philosophy of leadership? How would you describe your leadership style?
Okay. So basically, this one is collective leadership. Right?
Right, sir.
So my leadership style is empowering appropriate people in the system so that there is a feeling of belongingness among everyone connected, everyone concerned. This feeling will extract the best from each person.
Right.
The amount of quality work that can be extracted for the benefit of both students and institution will be very high. I am very much satisfied with the result that I could see so far. And I believe that I can improvise and update the style of functioning to meet the needs of the hour.
Great, sir. Oh. So, being a trustee of Sai Vidya Institute of Technology, how do you strategize about the key programs and plans for the marketing and administration of your school?
Okay. So, the present day scenario is drastically different from what we had a few decades ago.
Right.
Now, there is a need to make the quality work done by the institution known to the student community.
Right.
To attract high quality students.
Right, sir.
This is possible only by increasing the visibility of the institution on the virtual platform. Once this is done, there is no need to do marketing. The name will have its own brand value.
Right.
So actually we have created a brand value like, so the among the student community, our institution is known for best teaching. So like this brand value, if we create, then so much of marketing will not be necessary. Right?
Right, sir.
And the goal is that creating brand value among about that, right? About the administration, I have mentioned the empowerment of all concerned is the best strategy.
Right, sir. So the education systems in India and other foreign countries are structured very differently. In your experience, what can an inbound student gain from studying here in your institute?
The education system in India, especially higher education, is controlled by the government and state universities. The education system in India is more focused on imparting broad-based fundamental knowledge. so that the student can build the future in any chosen field of engineering. Sai Vidya Institute of Technology in particular is very strong in making the student very confident in fundamentals and developing interest in subject of his choice in his branch of engineering and excel in the same. The college provides necessary platform for the same. And this is the strength of the college and also the uniqueness.
Right, sir. So how does the curriculum of Sai Vidya Institute of Technology ensure the best practice of industry?
To make the student industry ready, we have incorporated many out of the syllabus teaching learning processes. To elaborate on this, I can list a few academic activities as follows. Each department has an association with the professional bodies. Under this, we conduct many workshops, seminars, webinars.
Right.
And the students are encouraged to take part in online courses, like say for example, MOOC course, massive online open online courses, and NPTEL courses conducted by IITs. And we encourage students to take part in development of project work, which is a part of funded projects that are currently active in the institution. And because of this, every year, many students to take part in international conferences.
Right.
Right. And also we see that all the projects, most of the projects are done in the institution itself. Right?
Right, sir. So, what do you think should be the institute's top priority over the next 10 years?
Okay. For the next 10 years, the top priority is to make the institution to get an autonomous status so that we can directly interact with campuses across the globe.
Right.
See, once we are governed by the universities, state-controlled universities, we are not able to frame our curriculum. Once it is an autonomous institution, we will have the freedom of framing the curriculum. And also we can have tie-ups with foreign universities also.
Great, sir. So what do you see as Sai Vidya Institute of Technology's greatest strengths?
The greatest strength of our institution is excellent coaching, madam.
Right.
And the satisfaction level of outgoing students is the best parameter to judge the strength of the institution.
Right. So what are some of the biggest challenges you see both for higher education in general and for Sai Vidya Institute of Technology specifically?
That is, the higher education at present is generally controlled by the government policies and in particular to our college also.
Right.
So we'll be not having much freedom of altering the curriculum.
Right. So any suggestions you would like to give to the current youth and the aspiring students?
Okay. The advice given is to follow their passion. Not to be influenced by the liking and the disliking of others. If they like what they are doing, then they can bring out the best in them. And at the end, the satisfaction level in the life will be highest. It cannot be measured in terms of money earned.
Right, sir. So what are some plans that you're currently or will be designing for Sai Vidya Institute of Technology's international affairs and our students?
Right now, we are able to make our students to participate in the international conferences and take part in project presentations. We will plan autonomous status first Later, we think of student exchange programs that can be undertaken.
Great, sir. So how do you tend to establish a healthy relation and environment in your institute?
Now, we have a friendly relationship between the students and the faculty.
Right.
And any institute which follows ethical and standard practices will always have good relation with the university. And this has been our observation, madam.
Right. So I'd like to ask you the last question for the day, sir. What would you like people to know about your institute that they may not know about?
This is the institution started and run by a set of professors imparting high quality education, right? And in fact, more than 20 of our undergraduate students have participated in top level international conferences. And for some of the presentations, funding travel grants and funding also has been done by organizations, right? And one more thing is two students of France have undergone internship in our institution. And in 2020, few more students from France were supposed to come for internship, but due to COVID, they could not make it up.
Right, sir. Okay. Thank you so much, sir, for your time today. I'm really grateful that you gave us this opportunity, and I'm sure this is going to help the students of the college a lot.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Have a good day, sir.